How are you feeling about the 2024 election?
I'm a bit terrified.
Nervous?
Because?
It's kind of the difference between democracy and not democracy.
Really worried about people who want to legislate against other people living their lives.
I feel so bad for the next generation that we've left a disaster. It's a hot mess. Maybe we need to go back to kindergarten and we need to learn how to compromise.
This is the best answer we've ever had on the show.
It is. What issues concern you most as you get ready to vote in 2024?
The migrant crisis, especially in this city.
For me, one of the biggest things is getting back to governing.
Oh my gosh, the preservation of democracy.
I think abortion's a big one, women's rights. A lot of things, you know, what's happening with in Israel.
Who's
there's
calling
crazy
us?
Things.
Gone.
Dupont, I'm on television. Quit calling me.
Charles always gets a phone call. Our first guest is a presidential historian and Pulitzer Prize-winning author. Thank you very much. We're talking about Jon Meacham. He's written many, many popular books, including New York Times bestsellers. I don't think you know you don't know how to write it. You don't know how to write anything but bestsellers, Jon Meacham.
Oh, I can do. I can. Try.
Oh, hold that thought on Abraham Lincoln, Thomas Jefferson, Andrew Jackson, and George H.W. Bush. Just to name a few. He's also an informal advisor to President Joe Biden, who will be giving the State of the Union address coming up very soon. Something tells me that you may have a hand in that, Mr. Meacham.
Just a hand, just a hand. I help President Biden's my friend. I help him when I can.
When you see the public, the people who vote, say, terrified,
nervous,
and things like that, you should be excited for an election. When you hear that from the public, what's the first thing go through your mind?
This is like 1860. It's that elemental. That was a presidential election where we had to decide what was our, not just what was our difference about policy, what did we want to pursue about this or that, but what was our common understanding of human identity. Mm-hmm. It's that fundamental. And what Donald Trump has brought us is this elemental struggle between the rule of the strong versus the rule of law. Mm-hmm. And for all of our failings...
People keep saying democracy's at stake. We heard that a lot.
It is. Tonight. And democracy's not just a form of government, right? It's a way of seeing each other. If we don't see each other as equal standing in dignity, then we can dominate each other. Mm-hmm. And the point of the United States, the first nation ever founded fully on an idea written by a boring white guy like me, Jefferson.
That's how you described yourself. Mr. Boring White Guy, you said that.
But it was, for we've been out of compliance with the Declaration of Independence longer than we've been in compliance with it. Mm. But people who look like me are the ones who set the standard. We went out and said, this is the idea we are going to live up to, and we're going to seek to live up to it. And if you get into a struggle where if you lose and you just say, well, we're going to change the rules, or I did it, so therefore it's okay, then we're not seeing each other as equals anymore. We're seeing each other as reflexive rivals or enemies, and that's the climate that we're in. We don't have to be. We choose to be.
You think we choose this, Jon? I mean, you
Absolutely.
See, people on both sides are unhappy. People on both sides are unhappy with Joe Biden. People on the other side are unhappy with Donald Trump. People say we don't have really two good candidates to choose from.
Well,
that's how most Americans feel.
It is, but we've been unhappy since the third chapter of Genesis, right? Since we got kicked out of the garden.
Have we been this unhappy, though?
I think, well, let's think about it this way. In my world, we have a debate about were we founded in 1619 mm-hmm. or 1776. I think neither. The United States of America, as we understand it today, was founded in 1965. The first integrated electorate
Wow.
in the United States was in 1968, 20 minutes ago, historically. The Immigration and Nationality Act that helped change the country, the Civil Rights Act, the Voting Rights Act. We're 55 years old or so. And so the notion that we were unhappy because of the choices, sure. I mean, we would all love to have Lincoln running against Kennedy and you're not really going to lose, right? But that's not reality.
Mm-mm.
And reality is, this is where we are. The choice is very stark. I personally, I'm not a Democrat. I'm not a Republican. I voted for presidents of both parties. But I honestly believe that there's a patriotic imperative to vote for President Biden against former President Trump.
Are you concerned about his age?
But you're also a friend of Joe Biden's, too.
So I am, but I believe this. So take it for what it's worth. That's why I said that. Take it for what it's worth.
Okay, but go ahead, Charles.
But are you concerned about his age?
I'm concerned about my age in particular. No, the older I get.
Yeah.
No, but I'm not. But I understand that you can't tell half the country that they're just wrong to worry about something. Mm-hmm. So he's got to show us and not just tell us. I can sit here and tell you that I've talked to him and I've never had any doubts about his capacity and thing. But why would you believe me? For mm-hmm. the same reason you just mm-hmm. said. So he's got to show us. You can't just stand for re-election. You've got to run for it.
But there are so many people, John, who are concerned about his energy, his vitality.
Sure.
Are those not legitimate concerns, in your opinion?
Let me be very clear. Of course they're legitimate concerns.
Okay.
Of course they're subject, he's 81 years old. Mm-hmm. The presidency is like an iceberg in general. You see a little bit of it, but imagine the cares and concerns that they have that we have no idea about. It's incredibly difficult. What I can just tell you from my own peripheral experience is that I'm not worried about his ability to do the job. That doesn't mean that you shouldn't be.
Yeah.
And you have to watch him and decide. Mm-hmm.
So my concern, and let me rephrase it. Everybody's concern, if President Biden was to win again, as bad as things were last time, we talk about the insurrection, whatever, and people saying the election was stolen.
Yeah.
Like, what's going to happen?
It's a it's a great worrisome question. And I, by the way, wouldn't have said what I said about the need to put the ideas of the country ahead of any policy disputes, which I said a second ago, if not for the lies about the election. In many ways, for all of whatever you may disagree about with Trump, in many ways, at least he was a recognizable American political character through the 2020 election, mm-hmm. an extreme version,
mm-hmm.
but you sort of knew you could find him on the GPS. You could not do that when people are storming the Capitol, which in my business, it's a bad thing. It's against the business model to say something's unprecedented because we're all precedent. That was unprecedented.
What did you make of Mitch McConnell's decision to step down as Senate Majority Leader, that he's going to do it in November?
Yep.
He's going to remain in the Senate.
And Mitch McConnell, agree or disagree, is, I would argue, the most powerful Senate leader in American history, if you think about it. He just changed jurisprudence with the Supreme Court.
Yes.
For at least two generations.
Yes.
Right? He's just an immensely powerful figure. And I do think, and it's amazing that this is where we are, given his essential partisanship, but he was a deal maker of a kind, right? President Biden could deal with him. And what's happening to the Senate is what's already happened to the House, right? It's just, it's becoming ever more polarized.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
I just don't think that's hard. Thank you.
Thank you.
We know you have to catch a plane. We thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Coming up next, Daily Show correspondent Dulce Sloan, she is here. We'll talk to her about the state of politics. And the return of Jon Stewart, he's back. You don't want to miss what she's got to say. You're watching King Charles. We'll be right back. What time?